Hey guys, it's Amina here. Welcome to my channel here on Amazon. We have some waffles that we'll be making, so definitely stay tuned for that. Make sure you hit that follow button wherever it's at on the screen because it's gonna be a long session. So we've had a little technical difficulties today setting up, and Amazon was down for like an hour, so I couldn't even like log in when I was got everything ready. So I ended up postponing our earlier session, and now we're back. So we're gonna be back. We're gonna be doing this for probably like 2 hours. The session usually lasts 2 hours. So definitely stay tuned then. You can definitely, like I said, click the follow button, come back. Once you're done with your shopping, you can check out all the list here and add anything to your shopping cart. But definitely welcome to my channel. All right, make sure that you can put in the comments or the conversation, wherever it's at here. You can put in like how you've been, what you've been doing. In fact, I'll write a little message on there so we start the conversation. All right, so let me do that. Let me walk over because I don't have my other screen set up yet. This is pretty new setup still, so we're trying to get it all worked out. Okay, so here we go. Welcome. I don't have another screen, so I'm just gonna type this out real fast. Next week we should have the other screen hooked up, so I don't have to come over here and type. All right, so we're gonna start off with the blender here, because first we gotta blend everything. So we're gonna be starting on the KitchenAid blender. Okay, and I'll try to come over and like move the screen, but again, guys, this is a new setup. Oh, let me send that message, I didn't send it. All right. Okay, there we go. All right, so again, welcome to my channel here on Amazon. My name is Sabina. We're going to make waffles today. I was gonna make pancakes and then I decided let's go ahead and do waffles. It's been a long time since I made waffles. We made it a couple weeks ago here on the live stream. And then before that, I think it's been like 3 years or something. So I'm like, all right, we have to start making waffles again. So I got everything all set up, I believe. If I'm missing anything, then I'll just grab it. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Let me wash my hands first. It's always a good thing to start off with, right? All right. Okay, here we go. So I hope you guys are getting all your Christmas shopping done. And if not, hopefully, you know, definitely check out the list down below. See if you see anything that you'd like to get your loved ones for Christmas. We've got some really nice equipment here. So my KitchenAid that's here, I've had this at least 16 years. I've used it tons of times. It's definitely a great piece of equipment, one of my favorite ones that I own. It's also one of the ones that I probably get used the most other than like the toaster. But definitely great piece of equipment here, heavy duty. It's like all metal, the whole thing's metal. After a while, like if you don't lock the lock, it does end up getting the head of it loose, which mine's a little loose. You'll know when I turn it on, it's a little loose, but you can tighten it up. They do have a big bolt there. But I don't like fooling with mine too much. I tightened it up like probably once or twice since I've had it. But like I said, I've had it for like 16 years. And I imagine I'm gonna have it like the rest of my life because it still is doing great. I have no issues with it. All right, and then I also have two of the mixing bowls, which I have more of these. I have the small ones, but for this recipe, since we're gonna be frothing up the eggs, we're gonna need another large bowl as well. All right, so the other large bowl is at the bottom, so you have the details on that. Let me shut that for a second. We've also got the mixing blade, which let me see if I have it in here. We've got so this one that we're gonna be using, and we have the other mixing blade, which I think my kids didn't put back, so let me just check where that's at real fast. Let's see if we can find the mixing blade here. Mixing blade in here? See the mixing blade. All right, We'll have to find the mixing blade here. Alright, so I'll get one of my kids to find it. So we can go ahead and start. Alright, because we can start with just this one. Alright, now I'll call down one of my kids to actually see if it's in the dishwasher. Alright. Hey guys, I need you one of you down here rooting alive and I can't find the mixing blade. Okay. So we will go ahead and mix this up, the first ingredient, and then we are going to need the mixing blade. So my older daughter is coming down to get that, wherever it's at. I'm not sure where they put it, so I'm gonna have them look for it. Also, I need the recipe book. That would be a good thing. Can you hand me the recipe book right there? It's right there. It's in the cabinet. I haven't put it in the cabinet there. I know. So they put the stuff back where it doesn't, where we normally don't have it. So that's why I'm trying to find stuff. Okay, so on this side, it's not in the recording, if you don't want to be on the recording. Okay. So we've got, I also need the tongs. You know the tongs? All right, so they're gonna look for the mixing blade while I'm getting the recipe. Now hopefully you guys can hear me good, because I usually have my lapel mic, but it was like not charged, even though I did charge it, so hopefully you can hear me really well. No, it's not in here, over here. Oh, I think it's, is that it right there in front? No, that's something else. All right, so I'll let her do that while we go ahead and start doing this. I'm mixing the mixing blade. I can't.
That?
Yeah, that's it. All right, thank you, sweetie. All right, so this is the blade that I was telling you guys about that we're gonna be needing. It's not important. So definitely, you know, make sure you get one of these. It actually comes with it, but the one that it comes with doesn't have this little rubber spatula, which is like the scraper part. It scrapes the side really good. So I highly recommend getting this one. Again, this isn't the normal one that comes with this. The one that comes with it, it's just a plane on both sides and it doesn't scrape the sides. So you're gonna need your spatula to kind of scrape it. Now, sometimes you still wanna do that and that's fine, but this one is so much better. So I highly recommend getting this one. In fact, mine's about needing to be replaced. It looks like it's getting a little bit beat up there. All right. I said, I've had my whole set for like 16 years. All right, so let me know if you guys can hear me good or if you need me to lower the Christmas music because I got the Christmas music playing behind you. All right, so we've got the first ingredients. We need flour, salt, sugar, baking powder. So let's get the baking powder. I've got everything else behind me. So. Now remember, this is baking powder, not baking soda. So we got the baking powder. Remember, baking powder, not baking soda. And then we need to get the flour and the sugar, which is already here. Oh, I didn't put these on the actual stream either. So I was gonna put these. These are the Hawking ones, the containers. I had it on my last stream. So, you know, if you guys want to check out my other cooking videos, make sure that you go ahead and follow. And you can go into the live stream tab or Amazon Live tab, and you can see all the kitchen stuff that I recommend. And I believe I put it on there. But if not, go ahead and follow, and I'll make sure after the stream that everything that you see here, I will put on a list that you guys can buy from, okay? So if it's not listed below, for whatever reason, like these things, I normally put on the list below, but it looks like I might have forgot them. I will put it on a list that you guys can easily buy these from Amazon. All right, I absolutely love these things. I have the medium size as well as the large size, okay? And they even have a little small size too. But I promise you guys, after the live stream, if you follow me, I will go ahead and put this up in a shoppable board in my storefront that you can easily get these. All right, like I said, I absolutely love these things. All right, so first we're going to go ahead and do the flour, the salt, sugar, and baking powder. Okay, so we're gonna move this back a little. All right, hopefully you guys can see pretty good. It gets kind of cluttered when you get a lot of stuff. Okay. Still pretty new to this whole setup down here, so yeah, these guys are my guinea pigs here. And and dealing with like, how am I gonna set up future videos like this? A lot of my followers requested last night that I do more cooking stuff. So I was like, all right, fine, I'll do more cooking stuff. I've even have viewers just like yourself come back and rewatch them and cook with me. So I found that out the last 2 days. So people have been rewatching the videos and cooking. Like they order the stuff below and then they come back onto the video and rewatch it. All right, so let's go to the ingredients here. And I'll share my my recipe with you guys. I'll share it with you when I get done like putting everything together. So make sure you do follow. Hey, Evans, we're making waffles again. We had a little technical difficulty. Like Amazon Live was down for a bit, but it's back, so I'm back. All right, so, and my mic didn't end up charging last night, so I don't have my mic on. All right, so we've got the flour, the salt, sugar, and baking powder. Salt we're not gonna put in here. I've got, my butter has a little bit of salt in it, so if you have salted butter, don't add extra salt, okay? All right, so let's see. We're gonna probably double this. So the recipe that I'm doing is double the recipe that I'm gonna give you guys. All right, so let's see. It's gonna be 1, 2, 3.5 cups of flour. Oh, look, I even have one in here. Let's take that one out. That's probably from the cookies. We did cookies all last week. Or yeah, was it last week already? Yeah, it was last week. Can you imagine? It's already been a week. All right, so we've got 1, 2, three and then 1/2 cup, which I just basically put it in there and kind of maneuver it around and like, okay, 1/2 cup. So 3.5 cups and then salt, which we're going to omit the salt because we have salted butter. We've got sugar we're going to do next. So we're just going to put this back behind me. Okay, and then we've got 1/2 cup of the sugar. All right, so 1/2 cup sugar. I gotta refill my sugar container. Okay, this one's gonna go behind me again. All right, so I don't have a whole bunch of clutter everywhere. Okay, now we need the baking powder, which is right here, and we need 1 tablespoon of that. And since we're doubling it, we could technically put 2 tablespoons, but I'm actually gonna just put 1.5 tablespoons because baking soda is actually pretty strong and you don't want to double the baking soda at most times, so, or it's just too much. So I usually half it when I double my recipe. All right, then we have to mix that. So we're gonna mix this with the KitchenAid. This recipe the same exact one since the early 2000s. All right. Okay. Plug your ears. Thank you, Evans. Okay, this is really nice because it avoids you having to do that little canister where you put the flour in. What would it be called? Can't think of the name right now. But you don't want to do that when you have a mixer like this. You just put it in and mix it up. Now, good thing to do is to mix it at the bottom too. So I just kind of like scoop it up the bottom to the top and then I add it back on to my mixer and do it again. And that's just to make sure that I have incorporated the baking soda, right? Baking powder. Incorporated the baking powder into the flour really well. Okay. So now it's gonna be really fluffy. Okay, so that's that. That's done. Pretty easy there. And now we've got to do in the next bowl, we're gonna be doing the eggs, the milk, which I need to grab the milk, butter, and if you have applesauce, you can even add applesauce or apple butter, okay? But we don't have that today, so we're not gonna be adding that. You can also add jelly if you want, or you can add blueberries or dry blueberries. It's just whenever you do dry blueberries or dry fruit in general, one, you wanna make sure they're bite size. Two, you wanna rehydrate it with hot water, so just leave it off to the side and let it like sit in the hot water for about 10 minutes, then strain it, add a little sugar to it, or brown sugar, it tastes really amazing. So if you wanted to do like a cranberry one, maybe we will make a cranberry one. I do have some fresh berries here too that we're gonna put on top, but let's do a cranberry one today. So let me get the cranberries, let me get the milk, and I already have the eggs and I already have the butter, so let me grab those. Walnuts or pecans too, which is really good. I'm gonna put it on this side so I don't have to reach over. I don't know if I have pecans though, so we can check that in a second, but we need to get the eggs. So I got the eggs here. Mine is just from my local store, so I got a Wegmans near me. I don't know if you guys have it where you're at. They're pretty much right around the northern east coast. So I am right outside DC and we've got plenty of Wegmans around here. All right, it's a family-run grocery store. Well, family-owned, I guess not family-run, right? So, family-owned. Okay, so I got my eggs, I've got my milk, which mine is almond milk, and mine's unsweetened vanilla. You can use any type of milk you want. It's the same ratio, 1:1, okay? And then I've got my butter, which again, I've got vegan butter. You probably had normal butter. You can use the salted butter, just don't use as much. And if you have a lightly salted one, that's probably better. This one's lightly salted with sea salt. So I absolutely love this one. I tried to find on Amazon to see if you guys that order food from Amazon Fresh, if they still have that service available, if they have it, but I didn't see it. So if you want to take a picture of it, you can, and look at another grocery store. All right. Oh. All right. Let's see. And then, if you have any applesauce or jelly or jam, if you want to put in the main ingredients, you can. Okay, so I'm gonna do one with cranberries and then one normal one. All right, you can even do peanut butter or powdered peanut butter with these. There's so many ways you can flavor these. All right, so I'm gonna grab a little bowl too and I'll show you what I do with these things. All right. I couldn't see them because I'm short and my cabinets are tall, so I had to really look and see if I saw them in there, but I saw them. Somebody threw them really high up there, probably one of my kids, because all my kids are taller than me. I made yogurt last night, made cheddar chicken broccoli soup today, get bread, baking in the bread. Oh my goodness, you've been busy. Heaven's been busy. So I made the yogurt, that's good. Okay, so I have something that you need to try with your chicken. Because I don't eat chicken anymore. I'm basically meat free now for the last 2.5 years, I guess, since 2019. But I still, now I've reintroduced fish back in my diet and seafood back in my diet, even though I don't eat it that much. Mostly vegan diet here. But I do have a good thing to do with your chicken. So if you end up like pounding it like with one of those little hammer things, you can do it in a Ziploc bag and then add your yogurt to it. So get your chicken breast, you know, make sure it's de-thawed if you have it frozen. Put it in a Ziploc or put it in a bag. And add your yogurt to it, but make sure you smush down your chicken so it's kind of like flatter and more tender, and then add your yogurt in it and let it marinate for at least an hour. If your house isn't that hot, you can do it like that. And then once you do that, you can put Indian spices on it, like a masala, chicken masala, and then you're gonna slice up your chicken And throw that in some oil on a pan, just a little bit of oil, like a tablespoon. And it's gonna be really, really, really good. You can put it with white rice, and you can even add whatever other Indian sauce to it. But hopefully you got that. So basically, chicken breast, you know, tenderize it, throw your yogurt in it, let it sit for at least an hour or two or overnight, and then put whatever spices you like on it. It's gonna be super tender and soft. I used to make it all the time. And yeah, and then fried it up. It's really, really good. Okay, so back to this. You can even add a can of tomato sauce, and that's really good too. Sounds good. Oh good, I'm glad you heard me. I'm not really sure because, you know, I don't have my little mic on today. Okay, so we've got the eggs we're gonna be separating, and then we'll add in the milk. So for this recipe, I'm doubling it. So you're just gonna use half of this, but I will give you the recipe. I'll bring it over there once we're done mixing all this stuff up, okay? So I need 8 eggs, so this whole half, right? And I gotta separate it. So the egg whites go in here, the egg yolks go in there. And I'm gonna need a bowl or something to put these shells in. I think I saw this on Rachel Ray one time where she did this, and I was like, oh, that's smart. You can also do it in a strainer. I've seen people do it in a strainer. One more, I think. That's 6. We need 8. So now I need 2 more after this. Right? Yep. And you can make these vegan too. It's just we're not making them vegan today. Because you just wouldn't put eggs, really. That's good. All right, let me wash my hands. Okay. So now I got the eggs in there. Put that back in the fridge here in a little bit. And then we can toss this when we clean up. So the next thing we're going to have to do to this, let's see, we did the large eggs, we separated them, and then we gotta do the milk, we've got to do, let's see, the butter, let's see. So I got to whip the egg whites to soft peaks, and then we're gonna fold in. I had to remember. Like I said, I made this last week, but I haven't made this recipe before last week in a while, so gotta remember all the steps. So here we go. Try to keep all the spaces clean a little bit better this time. Okay. Yes. They are gone. We're gonna make more cookies tomorrow. This is going to take a little bit as well. Okay, so what we were just doing, we were whipping up the egg whites, okay? So I'm gonna show you what it kind of looks like right before it's done whipping, because I know it's hard for you guys to see. All right, so it kind of looks foamy like that, but that's not done, okay? You're gonna know when this is like a hard peak on it, which I'll show you what it looks like. It kind of changes color, it's more like white. And Evans, if you didn't hear me, yes, we did finish the cookies yesterday, and we're gonna make more cookies tomorrow, because I told a place that I go to and eat out a lot that I'll bring them some cookies. So we're gonna be making more cookies tomorrow, so look for that. I have to figure out a time. Check it. You just have to lift it up. Chloe, stop barking at things. Okay, yeah, that's done. So see, now it's like a hard peaks on there. It's kind of like white. It also is not like sliding out. You see? That's what you're looking for. All right. So this one's done. So we're just gonna put this aside. You're done with this piece, so you can put that in the sink, some warm soapy water or something. Okay. And then we are going to take the other one that we just did. This one's the one with the eggs and the flour, okay? So eggs and flour in this one. And we're going to go ahead and get the other mixer on. So this one is the flathead mixer. And we've got to add a couple more things to this. So we've got to add butter and milk, okay? So here's my butter. And for me, since I'm doubling this, I'm going to use a 6 tablespoons, all right? So 6 tablespoons, mine's measured on it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on there. And I gotta double it. So if I want to, I can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can do literally the whole thing if I want, like all up to here. But I'm not gonna put that much butter because I don't want mine really, really buttery. You can choose to do yours really buttery. I usually sometimes even omit the butter, like I don't even use it. So this is not a required step, but if you want it to taste a little bit buttery, obviously use butter and put it in there. Okay, let me see if I can find a nice sharp knife. I think I want to go with this one. All right, I should put these on the list. I've had these a long time, like a very long time. It's like one of my first knives. So I'll have to put that on the other list. Okay, so I'm just gonna put like, I don't know, 8 tablespoons in mine of butter. Now you can mix this with your flour before you do the eggs, so it actually incorporates a little bit better, but I didn't do that, so that's fine. Usually I always like to mix my butter and my flour before I add any other ingredients. I'm just kind of spreading mine out. Also, if you make the butter chilled, then it also is really good to add. And then you cut it into small little cubes. And then it'll melt evenly through whatever you're cooking. Mine's still a little cold, so because I just took it out not so long ago. Not frozen, chilled. All right. I'm going to go put my butter back in the fridge so it doesn't melt. Here on the countertop, and I'm gonna put my eggs back too. All right. Since we've got a real kitchen here, we don't have a studio with assistants. I have my kids sometimes, but they're not down here right now. So. Now we can go ahead and we're gonna mix this. I think, let's see, the milk. Now we just need the milk. But before we do the milk, I'm gonna go ahead and mix the butter, the eggs, and the flour. And you can have the guard on here. I don't have my guard on. It comes with one. At least back when I got this one, it did, and that was 16 years ago. Thanks for following. Oh, what kind of cookies am I making tomorrow? I just saw that. Okay, hold on. I think we're gonna make, here, I'll wait till this is done. Wait till it's done and I'll answer your question. Okay, so you basically mix this until it looks like, what would it be called? Sand? Until it looks like a sand consistency, and I'll show you. I'm gonna get some on a spatula. So Evans was asking, what type of cookies am I making tomorrow? So we're gonna make chocolate chip and the thumbprint ones with the jelly in the middle, all right? And then after that, we might make the other two again, but we're only gonna mix like the just one batch instead of like we made like a bazillion batches last time. We made 400 cookies last week. All right, so we've got, it looked like sand, right? So that's the sand consistency on it. All right, so give me a second, guys. We got a person that wants to come into my live and be rude, so let me go ahead and take care of that. When I have my new setup next week, hopefully I'll have my other screen here that I can easily just take care of it here. All right, but either way, I have to walk around and I have to go take care of this. All right, give me a second. Hopefully next year we'll get I'll be able to hire an assistant. So only with you guys' help with helping promote this channel can I afford to get an assistant. But anyhow, maybe next year. All right, so we've got, we did the egg separated, we did the milk, we did the butter, and you can do applesauce if you want it like more like squishy basically. And it's just really nice flavor with applesauce, but again, we don't have applesauce right now, so we're not gonna do applesauce. Any fruit, butter tastes good as well with it. All right, so we're done with that. Now we are going to go ahead and fold the egg whites that we went ahead and whipped into this nice, meringue almost, you could say, and put them in here, okay? Now you always want to put the wet ingredients into the dry ingredients. All right. All right, so we don't need this. Don't want that. And this is an annoying song. I don't know about you guys, but I don't know. It's just weird. Alexa, skip. Thank you for your follow. I can barely read your name from here. Let's see. Delilah? Did I say that? Is it Delilah? Did I say that right? All right. So we've got the egg whites that we whipped, and we've got the mix that we put the milk. Oh, we didn't do the milk yet. Okay, we do need that thing back. All right, so this is where you put the milk in. All right, let me grab this back over here. We gotta rinse it off a little. Luckily, I didn't put it in the sink. I just put it beside it. All right. I had to take care of that comment, and after that, I forgot to add the milk. All right, so we're just gonna put that back on. Luckily, I didn't, like I said, throw it in the sink. I just put it beside the sink. All right. Okay, so we got to do still the milk. We've got 3 cups of milk because I'm doubling the recipe. And after I go ahead and add this and mix it in, I'll come and give you guys the recipe. All right. And again, use whatever milk you like. It's equal parts. I'm gonna let that spin and add the other two. Now you gotta wait till it incorporates a little bit. So then a splash. Oh, did I set off your Alexa? Yeah, that happens. There was a commercial about it. I'm not gonna say it again, but there was a commercial about the Echoes, and every time that commercial went off, all my Echoes responded that was in the vicinity. This was a couple years ago. We're getting there. Let's get it incorporated. All right, we are done with this stuff now. Okay, let me show you. So now it has the milk in it, like it's supposed to. All right. Sidetrack when I had to moderate the comment. Okay. So we're going to scrape this down a little so I don't have all this stuff on it when I put it in the sink this time, or beside the sink, just in case I miss something else. But. Okay. I love live cooking shows. Live cooking shows. Okay, let me just grab something and put this on. All right. Okay, now we've got all of that done. So that's what it looks like. And I'll come over and give you the recipe. Let me just rinse off my hands real fast. Okay. All right, ready guys? You can screen capture it. So I doubled it, okay? You can double it if you want to. All right, hopefully you got that. Okay, so I'm done with all that. Yeah, this is my personal recipe book. Made this back in 2009. You didn't get it? Oh, okay, hold on. I'll walk back over there. Okay. Got it? Evans, did you get it? Okay. Next things next. Now we gotta mix these together. So we've got, this is the flour mix that we did, and we added the milk to that. And now we've got the egg whites here. So let me just clean up a little. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and add this into here, and we're gonna fold it in, so little bits of scoops. I got something on my mixer, I think. I don't know. Either way, it's probably just some of this, actually, now that I think about it, because it's brown. That's what I got on it. All right, So again, you just put some in there and you just mix it a bit. And you're gonna just gently fold. Thanks, I was taking the bread out. Oh, okay. What kind of bread did you make? I haven't used my bread, like I don't have a bread machine anymore. I just make it straight in the oven. I'll make bread for you guys one day in the oven. It's actually really simple to make a bunch of bread in the oven. But you gotta know some techniques. What type of bread did you make? Chloe, lay down. My dogs are fighting over a pillow down here. She's upset that my other dog got the good spot, I guess. She wants the spot. Chloe, just lay down. You're fine. She's staring at me. Just white bread? Are you gonna make it into something or just for sandwiches? All right, all I'm doing is folding it in, incorporating it. Just as long as you don't get rid of all the fluff, you're fine. So it's kind of just keep folding it in until you don't see any more of the white peaks. So when you don't see any more of the white, that's when it's really incorporated. But just keep slowly adding this in and then keep gently folding it. Okay. Hey, you two, don't fight over the pillow. Let me go break them up so they're not fighting over the pillow over here. Okay, I'll just throw that in there for now. All right, come on, Chloe, let's go over here. Come on. My dogs have to be with me, like, all the time. So, they're over here in the corner. Just for sandwiches. Okay, good. Going to make banana bread, nut bread tomorrow. Oh, that sounds good. I haven't made my banana nut bread recipe in a while. I've got a good one for you, if you want it. You want to take a picture of the banana nut bread one? Let me see if I have right here. Give me a second. Is it in this book? Let me see. Banana nut bread. Banana nut bread. Yep, it's in this book somewhere. Okay, I'll get you a picture of it. Okay, here it is. Here's the banana nut bread that I make. And it's all broken down really well. I've actually spent my time and worked this all out really well. So there's the banana nut bread recipe. You got it? Let me know when you got it, Evans. Okay, good. Evans said he was making banana nut bread and I have a recipe for that, so. Maybe eventually I'll make this. My daughter wants me, my older daughter, she's gonna be 18 here in another couple months. She wants me to make this into a cookbook so she can easily have it. And we're starting that process like a year ago. We actually were formatting it into like a cookbook more, but it was taking way too long. So I think I'm just gonna hire somebody when we're actually ready to make it into a cookbook so I don't have to format it myself. Yeah, so it would just be a lot easier. I really don't want to have to type all these things out again. I just want to scan it to somebody and they can do that. Alright, so we've almost got it all incorporated. Again, when all the little white pieces kind of get incorporated into the batter, then it's done. So, it's going to lose some of the fluff. It'll lose like a third of the actual fluff. But you're gonna still have a lot of fluff in there because all that air is now in there. All right, and that's gonna get really soft. So it's gonna look like this, okay? See all the air bubbles? It's probably with the light, probably not right there. Probably like right here. All right, so now we've got the waffle makers behind me. They are super hot right now. You can find the details on those below, so definitely check that out. Let's see, what do I need now? Well, let me get this knife out over here, because I'm done with that. And I'm done with those, so we're good there. And I'm done with this. And I don't think I need any of this other stuff, so let me put some stuff back. Okay, so clean up all the stuff I'm done with. This was for the craisins. So we're gonna go ahead and rehydrate some craisins for one of our batches. And we're gonna also crush up some of our pecans, kind of like we did with cookies last week when we made the oatmeal cookies. Same thing. All right, because they were so good, we're gonna make some cranberry and pecan waffles. All right, so I'm done with my cookbook, so I'll just put that over here. And I'm done with this. Again, I like cleaning up as I go so I can visually see that I didn't miss anything. All right, and we already dealt with the milk, which I'll put that back in a second. All right, so let's go ahead and rehydrate some of these craisins. So I just get like, I don't know, a little small bowlful, because we want to make sure we have enough for half of the batch. We're not going to make them all with this. This is a big bag too. So now you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna add hot water to that. And I've got Insta-Hot over here. So I highly recommend everybody have Insta-Hot. It's really great to make tea too. All right, so that's gonna soak for about 10 minutes or so. So it's rehydrated so they don't taste like fruit leather. And the pecans we have. Now you're gonna wanna crush these. I don't know if I have my mallet over here. I did have it over here, but I think my kids put it somewhere else. Let me see if it's in the drawer over here. Well, I go walk over there. Let me go put my milk away. Search for the mallet. All right, so this is for crushing the pecan nuts. Okay, let me just get my area cleaned up a bit so I can actually bring over my cutting board where I can actually do this. My dogs are fighting over the pillow again. Okay, so like I said, I had some fruit on here and I had this to rinse off. I'm gonna wipe this down really fast to make sure it's clean. Alright. You want me to put down another pillow? You don't have enough pillows? Alright, let me throw down another pillow for her. Here. Okay. It's funny, they won't jump on the couch. They won't go around and jump on it so they can actually see me. They have to stay near me, so they won't walk around the couch. All right, so we've got pecan pieces. We're just gonna crush them in the bag, because there's only a little bit left. So we're just gonna like flatten them out, and then just take your mallet, and you could use either side, doesn't matter. We go through a lot of pecans in this house. We all like pecans. We put them in our food too, like our regular like food. They give such a good taste to your food. So all I did was crush them up. All right here, I'll put them in a bowl so you can see. All right, so that's them crushed up. Those are the pecans. And we've got the craisins with the hot water rehydrating here. And we've got the waffle mix there. So we are gonna need these, and we're gonna need to move the KitchenAid because we're gonna bring over one of these things, okay, behind me. Because this is gonna be the easiest way for you guys to see instead of me moving the camera closer to that. So let me go ahead and move some stuff out of the way. We're gonna move these over. We're gonna use that in a second. Move it so you guys can see a little bit more. Okay, we good? Let's see. Move the plates. Actually, we'll leave the plates because we need the plates to put the waffles on. So we should only need two plates. So let's see if you can actually see the plates. All right. Try to make this a little bit easier for you guys to watch. All right. We don't need the mallet anymore. All right, so let me move this thing out of the way because we're done with that. And we're gonna go ahead and bring over the waffle maker. So we're just gonna put this behind me. I'm gonna set up everything over here to actually do it, but again, it's a little far for you, so I'm just gonna move it closer. Okay, just gotta be careful moving it, because it is hot. All right, that's why I got these. I always put paper towels underneath them, so in case any of the oil drips, it's less to clean up. All right, where is this thing plugged in at? Oops, I got it plugged in up over here. So you can see. Yeah, it's super hot because it's been warming up. If I just use this one, that's the square one, this is the round one, right? It really doesn't take long in this one because this one's two-sided. It's a top and a bottom. Highly recommend. Takes, you know, so much more or less time with this one. Okay, we're gonna kind of tilt it this way so I have enough room to open this thing up. Yeah, and let's just use this one. We'll leave that one over here, okay? This one is the square one. Now, this one does fold pretty good. It has a little handle that folds. All right, this one, unfortunately, is out of stock right now. But definitely, if you get your hands on it, I definitely recommend, if you want a square one, that one. But I absolutely love this one because it's double-sided. I can flip it and get another whole waffle at the bottom. So it's so much faster. All right, so we're just going to use this one today. Let's redo the oil here. That's it telling me that this is ready. Okay. So hopefully you can see this really well. It looks like you can. Okay. So I don't need these. Gloves, so we don't need to keep that open. Okay. So they light up green when they're ready. And then you just lift it up. Make sure that you do get one of these things. I needed to put it on the list, but I forgot. So this is just a basting brush, and you're just gonna put some olive oil in a bowl, and you just coat the bottom here, okay? And then you coat the top, all right? So you make sure you get all of it coated really well. So you don't want it to stick, okay? And now you're gonna take your mix, and you don't have to lift this heavy thing because it does get heavy and it can hurt your wrist. You can get a scoop and just scoop it out. But I'm just gonna, you know, do it out of here today. So I'm just gonna hold it. All right, and you're just gonna put about a cup in the middle and it's gonna spread out. Maybe a little bit more than a cup. It might not be as much as I need. And then you're gonna flip it, do the same thing. You're gonna open it up. You're gonna coat to the top and the bottom. Now, if yours has removable grates in the middle, do not put them in the dishwasher, okay? Do not put them in the dishwasher. Just use a little warm water and wipe them down, and then just re-coat it with the olive oil or whatever hot high temperature oil you have, okay? And then we're gonna put some more in the middle. Again, I'm putting like a cup, a little bit more than a cup. It's gonna fill in all the gaps. And I don't want it like coming out the sides. All right, so I'm just gonna flip that again. Now it's getting all incorporated in there. And then we get to see what it looks like. So while we're waiting, let's go ahead and drain the cranberries. These are the, what are these called again? Craisins. These are the craisins that we are rehydrating in hot water. So I'm just gonna dump them in here. Get all that water out. And then I'm just gonna put them right back into the bowl. Alright, so here we go. And now they're softer, okay? Really good. I recommend that you put some brown sugar in there because craisins are sour. Now let me get some brown sugar so we can mix in with that. Looks like my brown sugar is a big put back in the pantry. I've got my brown sugar here, and we're gonna add it to the cranberries. I'm just gonna add a little, just to get rid of some of that sourness. Maybe like a tablespoon. Well, they do make containers for these that keep brown sugar soft, but I don't use that much brown sugar a lot, so I just keep it in that bag. And then you just need like a spoon or something to stir it up. I've got this little cute little spoon. That's usually what I use for my tea or large drinks to mix in protein or something, but I have it down here. It's actually supposed to be upstairs. I've got a little spot in the morning that I make tea or I make like a little protein shake or a green drink, but I took this down here at some point, I guess, and it stayed down here. It needs to go back upstairs. I'll put it here so I remember to take it back upstairs after I wash it. All right, so that's what I did. I went ahead and added the brown sugar into that. Thank you, Evans, for your help. Okay, so this first batch is done, so we can pull that out and look at those. And then the next one we make, we're gonna make one of the fancy ones with the craisins and the pecans. So I could have put a little bit more batter because it didn't fill in the sides all the way, but you get the point. Here, I'll put a little bit more on screen so you can see it. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and take out the other one, I think. Is the other one ready or no? Let's see, let's peek in there and see if it's ready. It is. All right, so there's the other one. And again, so now we just go ahead and we're going to re-oil. About a cup of batter, a little bit more than a cup, it's like a cup and a half. It's gonna flatten out a little bit. You don't have to spread it or anything because when you shut it, it's going to go ahead and spread out. And I'm gonna lay these down so it doesn't get batter all over the counter. It just keeps it a lot cleaner. All right, so that's just the bottom half saying it's ready. So then we're gonna go ahead and add the rehydrated cranberries in here. While it's cooking the bottom here, it's kind of spreading out a little fast because I've been talking. All right, and then we're gonna add some of the crushed pecans. It's right in there. And again, mine's kind of going over the edge a little because I'm talking. So let me clean that up a bit. So you just get a paper towel and just kind of wipe the side. Of course, when it's hot, it's going to be a little harder to get totally clean, but like I said, I was talking so I couldn't get it in there fast enough. Okay, so sometimes it'll come out the edges. Again, you can just wipe it down like that. You can even get a butter knife and scrape it up. Okay. I didn't move too fast. It was coming out the edge. All right, now I gotta do this side. So we're gonna go ahead and do the oil first. Remember, you're gonna always put oil before you put anything on the grill plates. Okay, every single time. Okay, make sure you get the edges of the too. All right, and I'm gonna put this on. This time I'm gonna try to be a little faster. All right, okay, put that on, and then I'm going to do this. Actually, let's do the nuts first. Creamers. That last one has a lot of cranberries on because it kept getting stuck. Okay. And then let's sit and we're going to twist it. Thank you. Evans is saying that the waffles look good. They're kind of a little softer because I don't have the heat up that high, so I'm going to actually turn it up just a little bit higher. But we'll eat a little piece. Let's see. Highly recommend. I love this one because it makes the actual Belgium style waffles. Look how thick those things are. Okay. They actually makes the thick ones. All right. Highly recommend. So this has really deep pockets, all right? So you can put that syrup in it and it'll just settle in each of these little pockets, or butter, whatever you usually put on yours, jelly. Very good. You literally eat just like this. You can put some powdered sugar on it, like dust it. Very good. Highly recommend. All right, if you didn't get the recipe, I'm going to share it again in like 2 more minutes. Okay, if you didn't get the recipe, if you missed earlier when we were combining the ingredients, in 2 more minutes, I will give you the recipe. Okay, so I just looked at the time. So guys, check out the list below, the carousel and all the stuff there. Anytime that you come into one of my lives, make sure that you are a follower. You know, you get invites to special events. Like tonight we're doing waffles. Tomorrow night we're gonna actually do cookies. So love to see you back. We're doing chocolate chip and we're doing a thumbprint cookie with the jelly in the middle, or kolashki. It's usually called, or a jelly cookie it's usually called. So it's got a number of different names. Currently, we're waiting for this one to finish up. So I have a round one and I have a square one. We're not using the square one tonight. I did warm it up, but we're not using it right now. So if you're looking for a square one, you can check again below and you'll get the one that I have on there. Now that mine, the square one is out of stock right now, but it is only a single plate. So if you want a double plate, you can get that. Also, this one doesn't make this does make the big Belgian waffles as well. This one makes the big ones also, like this, the really thick ones. My older one that I had before didn't. It was like a flatter one, so that one I don't have anymore. All right, because I only got so much room in my cabinets. These things take up a lot of room, so make sure that if you do get one of these, make sure you have a dedicated space on the counter for it, or do you have enough to room in your pantry or underneath one of your cabinets. So this cabinet is designed to hold these and these big pots as well. All right, when I got my kitchen remade, I made sure that I had somewhere to put all these. Okay, so this is the cranberry with the pecans, and they turned out really good. Okay, hold on, let me see if I can get it off the edge here. It's kind of on the edge a little bit. Okay, so that's what that one turned out like. That is a cranberry with the pecans, all right? And then we'll have one more coming out just like that. And this is the other one. Same thing, cranberry with pecans. All right. And again, I told you in 2 minutes I'll give you that recipe. It's about that time. So I'm just gonna go ahead and load this back up, and then I'll come and share that my recipe with you, okay? Now this is a personal recipe that I put in my personal like family cookbook that I made for my family back in 2009. All right. So these we're gonna make a plain batch now. So let me add a little bit more batter into that. We're kind of going between the plain ones we're making and the other ones we're making. And that's the cranberry pecan ones. Put oil. Don't forget the oil, or I'll stick. And then you're gonna have a hard time getting it back up. Okay. It'll work after one, but it's gonna be hard to do another one. Piece of the pancake still in there, or waffle. There you go. Just got stuck on the edge. Thank you for following. Welcome to the family. All right, so we've got that. And I'm gonna go ahead and flip it. And then we're gonna do another one of the pecans with the craisins that we rehydrated with water, okay? I'm gonna get a spoon for this so I don't have to keep putting my hands in it. All right. I'm washing my hands again. All right, now I told you guys that I'm gonna share that recipe again with you. For all you guys that are just now tuning in, let me go ahead and do that. All right, so I'm gonna come around and I'm gonna put it in front of the screen, so just go ahead and screen capture it, okay? Make sure you screenshot it, okay? So here you go. That's the recipe we're making right now, but I doubled it, okay? So if you want to make just as many as I'm making right now, you're gonna double the recipe, all right? There you go. And of course you can get this on replay, so make sure that you follow and you can rewatch the replay. I don't remove the replay, so you can come back at any time, watch any of the lives again. If you want to share it with your social media, feel free to share it with your social media, because all the links and everything are on the replays. Once they're completed, they get shared. Let me go ahead and switch the Cuisinart thing, because I noticed I didn't move it over since we did this. So let me go ahead and go to the back of it. Sorry if there's some wiggling. All right, there we go. I just wanted to make sure that we're on this one. And everything else is down here too. So the calendar is right here. We've got a couple of the dishes that are on there as well. We've got the bowls on there and the plates on there. I've been using these bowls and plates for 2 years now. I really like them. And of course, they fit my kitchen really well. All right, this should be about done. Check that in a second. So how you guys doing tonight? Got any big plans for Christmas or Christmas Eve? So I'm actually having a get together on Christmas Eve here at the house for a couple hours. So all my neighbors all but two. Two of them technically don't live in the neighborhood yet, and I don't think they ever plan to. They have a lot here, but they just stayed at their house. They didn't move in. So basically they bought the lot for an investment one bought it for a family member. The other one bought it to rent out the house. Cause he renovated the place, but he has a really nice house down the road. So we got a pretty small neighborhood here. But all my other neighbors, I've got six other neighbors, they're probably gonna come over Christmas Eve and we're gonna have a little get together. Cheese and wine and crackers and nuts and olives and all that good stuff. I'm gonna put that one back in a little bit longer because it's not that dark. I'm gonna go a little bit darker. Turn up the heat a little bit. Okay, let's see how this one turned out. This one's almost done too. We're gonna just put it back in there. I wanted them a little bit browner. All right, so about another minute. But yeah, we're having some people over on Christmas Eve and we're gonna probably play pool. I got a pool table here. So we're gonna play pool. We're gonna probably put on a Christmas movie and just hang out. So I've invited some other people outside of my neighborhood as well to come. We'll see if anybody can come. A lot of people are working Christmas Eve. I am too. You'll see me here on Christmas Eve. Don't worry. I'll be doing a live at some point. Because I've got a bunch of stuff to finish up on the end of the year. So I want to make sure that I hit my goal here on Amazon. So if you'd like to share, like I said, the video and tell people to follow the page, that's great. That helps get me closer to my goal. but I am getting down like all my social media stuff systematized better. So I have all my stuff on my desktop. I just got a new desktop. Well, technically it's not new, it's like a used one. But I finally got a desktop this last 3 months ago just because I wanted a bigger screen to actually see my reports all on one screen in the morning and not have to take up more room or anything on my laptop. So I got a desktop one and I'm really liking it. In fact, I'm using it more than I use my laptop, which my laptop was my main computer for many years. Yeah, we're just gonna put this right on top. So that is, oh, you didn't see it. So let me get it closer. All right, so there it is. See, I wanted to brown it a little bit more. All right. Here, I'll take one of the other ones out and I'll show you. Come closer a little bit and then show you how that looks. Okay, let's take out the other one because it's ready too. Before it gets too brown. That's the one I stuck back in there. Okay, so there we go. It started getting a little bit too brown on the other side because I let it sit back in there for a little bit. All right, but it'll soften up as it sits here. That's the only thing about waffles. You better eat them fast or they're gonna soften up. Okay, unless you make really hard waffles, but I don't like, I like my middle of my waffle to be nice and fluffy, and the outside to be crispy. All right, now I'm gonna put some more in. Get some more oil, we'll see. Again, we're making two batches of waffles. All right, and we're kind of alternating between these, the plain ones, and the ones with the nuts and the cranberries. All right, so this one's gonna be a nut cranberry one. I'll put a little bit more nuts on this one because we're probably only gonna be able to make one more with these because I don't have too much more batter. And then we're gonna do cranberries, just kind of sprinkle in there as best I can. Kind of clump, they're kind of clumping a little bit. Make it a small pair of tongs, that would actually work really well. Okay. I'm gonna come out the side a little bit because I was taking my time again. Okay, now we're gonna do this side. Now again, I'm putting a cup, about a cup and a half, okay? And I've got enough in here to do two more, it looks like. So we're gonna do more nuts. Half of this cranberries, because we're gonna make one more cranberry, I'm gonna make one more plain one. Okay. So we've got enough for one more of both, okay? And here's my piece that I've been nibbling on. So if you guys have any questions about the stuff in the carousel, just let me know. Let me rinse my hands real fast. Okay. A good thing to have when you're making like stuff in your kitchen is leave one of your sinks. If you have two sinks, you know, if you have one sink, then leave your one sink full with soapy water, so you can easily just fill up the sink as you are cooking, and then afterwards you can, you know, easily clean it up. But of course mine's not today because my kids forgot to do dishes before we started this live, so, and they can't run the dishwasher when we're doing the live, so they're gonna have dishes to do after this. I told them to make sure the kitchen was clean. And they cleaned off the counters, which I was happy about, but they put all the dishes in the sink and not in the dishwasher. So they get to do dishes. Because I would have did dishes tonight if I just had to do these and whatever plates that we used up for our waffles for dinner. But they get to do them because they were supposed to do them earlier when I was running errands earlier. All right, so we've got, these should be about done. In fact, this top one looks about done. I can just kind of see it through it. Oh yeah, we'll say that one's done. It's close enough. All right. It's really because this one has the nuts in it with the cranberries. The beeper will go off. Sometimes I'm impatient. All right, so this is the one with the nuts and the cranberries. We made two of those. I've been nibbling on the ones that don't have the nuts and cranberries. I'll have to taste one of these here in a second to tell you how good it is. Oops, I didn't wait till it beeps. All right, let's wait till it beeps. So then we're not messing up the cycle. It'll beep here in a second. So let's try one of these. I haven't tried one of these yet. I won't eat a whole one. I'll just eat a little piece. Let's make sure that I get some nuts and cranberries in it. Let's see. There's a cranberry on this corner on this one. Here, I'll just, there's a little. Some cranberries right here. All right, so I'll just grab a little piece of, this is the craisins that we rehydrated and added brown sugar to it, and the pecans, all right? Now, if you wanna add cinnamon to that, it would taste really, really good. Cinnamon and nutmeg and allspice, Definitely, but my kids are sick of me putting cinnamon on everything, so I won't do that to them because I literally put cinnamon on everything. But I will put cinnamon on it once I put the syrup and the berries. In fact, while we're waiting, let's go ahead and prep the berries. This one should be about done though. That one's pretty much done, okay. It's because I opened it, and every time you open it, sometimes it resets the timer. All right, so we've got fresh raspberries, and they should be all good because they literally just came from the grocery store. You just have to make sure there's no leaves in there. And then these are the fresh blackberries. I'm gonna rinse those. Okay, let's take this one out and then we'll rinse those. there's that one. Okay. And any of you guys that are new, and make sure you follow, I'll share the recipe one more time at the very end, okay? The very end of us making this. We're almost done. We're on our last one here. So probably we'll be wrapping up in about 10 more minutes, okay? And then we're gonna plate some of these. Well, at least I'll plate mine. The kids can do whatever they want with theirs. I gotta get a little bit more oil, I think, because I won't have enough for the bottom. We'll see. I might. It might be just enough. Okay. So let's go ahead and put half of this in. Okay, I might actually make one extra one. Let's see. We'll see. There's not too much left in there. So we're just gonna use up the rest of these nuts. And we're gonna use up the rest of the cranberries on this one. All right, guys, we are almost done cooking these. We've got probably another, let's see, let me scrape down the sides. We definitely have another one, but we might be able to get a small little tiny one out of the rest. We'll see. It definitely is one. Okay, I might just make one more. It doesn't look like there's too much more extra at the bottom. Let me go ahead and rinse these, and then we'll check on this, and then we'll start plating one too, and I'll give you the recipe too. And I've got my paper towels here, which is always a good thing to have. I'm just gonna put these here so they can drain a bit more. All right, let's get to plating one of these while that last one's cooking. So I'll move these over a bit. Have room here. Put that over there. Okay. All right, so we're gonna plate, right? And then I want one of these ones, so I'm gonna eat one of these. In fact, I want one with all the craisins in it. I want the one that's really covered. All right, so let me go get the syrup. So I've got a couple things here. I've got maple syrup. I've got some more jelly, just like I put below the my favorite jelly that's in my advent calendar over here. And maple syrup. Okay, so I'm gonna put that to the side. Thank you, Evans. All right, that should be almost done, but let's make this one. I'm just gonna make one right now. And let's see, what do I want on mine? I do want cinnamon, so let me get some cinnamon. Cinnamon. I don't think I'm going to put nutmeg. We'll just do cinnamon. All right. And I'm going to do, I was thinking about making some whipped cream, which is really good and definitely highly recommend, but I'll skip it right now because then I'll have to get the mixer and, you know, another mixing bowl and stuff. And that's okay. I just really want to just eat it like this. All right. So Let's see. Do I want to use a spoon on this? Probably. Alright. Now this is cherry jelly. And I really love this jelly because it's not very liquidy. And do I want to use up the whole thing? There's only enough for one more in here. But I'll probably have another one, so that's okay. We'll just put one. I might not. I get full really easily. So especially off of these things. They're very filling. Alright, I do want some fresh fruit. So let me get some fresh fruit on mine. I've got raspberries and blackberries today because they're pretty good here in the winter, wherever they import them from. I'm gonna load mine up because I really want a bunch of these. All right, because again, this is probably gonna fill me up, honestly. All right, and then I'm going to put the maple syrup. Get you a little bit closer. I'm gonna move these a little bit more off the screen. You guys can see a little bit more. Alright, now we go ahead and we're gonna just drizzle that on there. Now you can go ahead and put powdered sugar if you want. But I'm just gonna do cinnamon on mine. I just like to lightly dust it. That is it. And if you have some whipped cream in a bottle, or if you make some whipped cream, just throw that right in the middle. So there you go. That is what we made. All right. So this one is the one with the pecans and the cranberries that we rehydrated. And the pecans we crushed. All right. So let me rinse my hands one more time because we've got another one here that we got to cook. And these should be coming out. And they are. Okay, so we've got all these that we made. We've got this one, we've got this one. And now we're gonna go ahead and take these two out. Oh, we only put one in. All right, I thought we put one on that side too. All right, so this is, again, the cranberries with the pecans, right? To kind of like brown it a bit. All right, there we go. And let's see if I have enough oil to do one more. There is barely any oil on this thing, but as long as it coats the grate, then we're good. Okay, we've got to get the top too. Hopefully I'll cover it all so I don't have to get more oil. It's literally like the last one. We just want to make sure it doesn't stick though. Okay. Looks like I had just enough. As long as it's all glossy, then you know you got it covered. So this one's gonna be a plain one since we just went ahead and finished the other stuff that we had. I try to fit it all in this one. Hopefully it won't overflow. Okay, that should be good. And then whatever's in the case, I don't think it's gonna fit in there because again, it might overflow. I put a little bit too much in it, but the first one I didn't put enough, and that's why I had a little bit extra on this one. All right, let me flip this around. It looks like it's gonna stay in there. That's good. Okay, there's nothing on that side. All right, so let me add water into this so we can go ahead and start soaking a bit. Of course, if I had a sink full of warm water would be better. See, I knew it was gonna overflow. It's overflowing on this side. This is why you put paper towels down. And the reason why I know it's gonna overflow is because, like I said, the first one I made, which I think I was nibbling on that one, that was this one, I didn't put enough batter. That's the only reason why that one had a little bit too much. That's okay. Just let it overflow and then you can always clean it up. This is why we put paper towels down, right? Always put paper towels under your machines so you don't have as much cleanup. Because this bottom base doesn't get hot. This doesn't get hot. Only the middle piece does. Okay? You can even scrape it off, like I said, with a butter knife if it overflows. Some of them have a drip pan, but even with a drip pan, I still go ahead and put paper towels underneath it, okay? It's just gonna make cleanup so much easier. So this is the one we just went ahead and prepped. then you can just go ahead and grab a fork and eat a piece, right? Alright. I'm gonna eat a piece while I'm waiting for this last one. If you guys have any questions about any of the products listed in the carousel, just let me know. I was gonna give you guys the recipe again for all you guys that are coming into the live now. You can even turn it sideways like this if it's puffing up a lot to keep it from expanding anymore. Because when I put it this way, it's gonna start to pop up a little. Alright. You can do that too. Just make sure it's cooked enough that you can turn it that way. Or you can just leave it upside down and that pressure will hold the bottom on. Alright, steaming a lot. Alright, let me give you the recipe. Remember, this is a two-sided one. There's a bottom and a top, which I love this, all right? Takes half the time to cook. And I have another one right over there. That could have even took even less time. But we're taking our time. We're not in a rush. All right, let me get the recipe on this one. Okay, ready? Go ahead and screenshot that. Okay, hopefully you got it. If not, come back to the replay. The replay will have it, and it's throughout the whole thing. Like, I've been sharing it throughout the whole recording of this. So you can just fast forward through it. Make sure you do, though, check out the links down below. Thank you. Like my nails? Yeah. My nails were a little bit longer the other day, but I just got them redone. And this time I didn't go as long. Even though I kind of miss my long nails. I really miss them. Like, I'm like, maybe I should have, like, had them put the extensions on. Oh, well. They're shorter now. But, thank you. I like them, too. I'm really into yellow right now. Alright, this should be finishing up any second now. And then we're going to call it a night for this. And then I'll be back on a little bit later for another live. So make sure you do hit the follow button. I think we might do some Christmas wrapping actually tonight. Because I just got another pile of Amazon presents. This just came in. So I think we might have to start wrapping because I haven't even started my wrapping. So we'll see. Maybe we'll do some wrapping tonight so we don't have to do it all on Thursday and Friday. I don't get too many gifts, but I still got gifts to wrap, so. And it does take time. And I make sure that I have wrapping paper too, so. Good, I'm glad. Yeah, we'll probably wrap. I'll just clean all this off during our break and eat, and then we'll come back and probably wrap some presents. It's like, it's gonna need to be done. Like, we're running too close to Christmas here. So, I just got my wrapping paper out somewhere. I don't know where my kids put it. See, this is the thing. When you have teenagers put away stuff, it's like, here, put this away. And then it disappears, and you gotta ask them where they put it. This should be done. Maybe because I moved it upside down. Let's see. Probably reset. Yeah, it looks done. All right, so again, this one is, this one didn't have nuts in it. It got a little bit brown, though, because of the stuff that was in this one that we just pulled out. But that is what it looks like. That's just a plain one, okay? The only reason why it's a little bit brown is because it had some of the stuff from this one that we just did on it in it, okay? There we go, guys. We've got tons. Now, this is two batches, and I already ate some of this one, and I've got another one there. This is two batches, all right? My daughter wants a piece. She snuck down behind the camera. So I hope you guys enjoy. Definitely make sure you follow. My name's Amina. Welcome to my page here on Amazon Live. And we'll see you a little bit later tonight. We're probably going to be wrapping presents. We'll just say we are wrapping presents because we'll definitely wrap some presents tonight because I just got some more in. I've got another bunch in the other room. So, let's get some wrapping. Let's put some Christmas ornaments on the tree. I haven't even put the Christmas ornaments on the tree yet. So we can, go ahead and get some wrapping done. So then I'll have to put the Christmas ornaments on the tree at some point tonight and tomorrow morning. So we can put the Christmas presents under the tree. So I'll be back probably, let's see, it's 6:30, we'll say about 45 minutes to an hour, I think, because then we can get the kitchen all cleaned up by then, have a nice clean space, and then we'll just wrap right in here since I already have this set up. So we'll just do it right here on this counter, but we'll just say an hour. So we'll be back in an hour. So 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. All right, guys, I hope to see you back. Again, make sure that you hit the follow button. We'll be back in about an hour to wrap some presents together and enjoy the recipe, okay? And if you are just now tuning in, make sure that you do follow so you can go ahead and watch the replay right after I close this out. It's gonna process for like a minute and you won't see it because I think it's instant for you. At least everybody else's ones that I've ever seen, it's instant for me to watch it. And I'll be back in a little bit. All right, guys, see you in an hour. So 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. All right, take care. Thanks for watching. You want me to turn it off? Yeah, hit it on the other side. Up.
Up here?
Hmm?
There you go. Yeah, you don't have to walk around.